Let me understand who I'm with tonight. Who here was born in the 60s? Are y'all representing? How about the 70s? In the 80s? In the 90s? Well, I tell you what, it's always great to see the many generations that hip-hop has affected. Because not only is it worldwide, but it also crosses all types of barriers and boundaries that we always knew were there. But somehow, music, and especially hip-hop, taught a whole lot of us how many of those barriers could also be knocked down. So hip-hop, I have a little something that I like to start off whenever I speak about hip-hop, but I have to tell you that when I'm invited to schools to speak, sometimes it can be something completely outside of the entire music life that I've had before, and still do to this day. But when I speak about hip-hop, it gets me riled up, and I get excited, and hopefully at some point or another during this speech, if I say something that you agree with, you can wave your hand, you can say, yeah, I get it, you can speak back to me, let me know that I am not alone in this. Hip-hop is unstoppable. Hip-hop is love. Hip-hop is charming, it's warm, it's hot, it's cold, it's inspirational, it's hard-hitting, it's motivating, it's crucial, it's necessary, it's flavorful, it's mind-blowing, mind-altering, forever-changing, it's a loose cannon, it's grown, and it's immature, it's worldwide, it's demanding, it seeks attention, it's mainstream, it's underground, it's black, it's white, it's gray, it's gloomy. It's revolutionary, it's leadership, it's honest when it's good, it's honest. It's soothing, it's moving, it's social, it's passionate, it's the ghetto, the hood, now it's the suburbs. It's New York, it's Philly, it's LA, Atlanta, it's DC, Chicago, St. Louis, Miami, North Carolina, South Carolina, it's the D. It's Ohio, Seattle, Houston, VA, New Orleans. It's even in Denver. It's Denmark, it's Germany, London, Japan, New Zealand, it's Joburg, Tbilisi, Croatia, it's Paris, it's Spain, Sweden, it is absolutely everywhere. The power of hip-hop cannot and will not be denied by any person, place, or thing. It is simply unstoppable. It has sculpted the way in which we speak and the way we dress. We have put new meaning into the words fly, dope, hot, deaf, word, stupid, dumb, for show, dog, keep it real, for shizzle on this, flavor, hype, blazing, on blast, game, drop it like it's hot, can't faze me, can't fade me, can't play me, paper chase, dough, cheddar, bread, cake, bird, swagger, nuller, joker, till the wheels fall off, slamming, janky, burnt, what it do, what it does, what's good, one time, kid, done, chicken head, scrub, Nathan, fat, L, stunting, fronting, put them together. That's a good one, I just got that one. I don't know how long y'all been saying it, but I just got that one. Let's put him together, he got it wrong. We are part of a continuous movement that is shaped and molded by the struggling, sometimes unethical and always suppressed youth of America, often under speculation is it art imitating life or life imitating art? Well, I tell you what, when I started in hip hop with my baggy jeans and my big gold dolphin earrings and my huge t-shirt and my asymmetrical haircut, that wasn't make-believe. That wasn't make-believe, so I definitely say that hip-hop is art imitating a life that is really real for a lot of us. Yes. And so at 16, I understood that the power of the microphone meant something. That to be able to have someone's ears meant that you had to say something that made some sense. You had to say something that was worthy of being heard. And I happened to have recorded a record called I Couldn't Understand You in 1986. However, it was written in 1982. About to take y'all on a history lesson real quick. I Couldn't Understand You was the first recording I had ever released, and it was about me being in love with a boy who was in love with a woman whose name started with a C and ended with a K. He was in love with crack. And in doing this song, my mission was to make an entire generation aware of all of the mishaps that could happen when you became involved with drugs. So it became, do not date a drug dealer, do not sell drugs, do not hang with people who take drugs, do not, this was my message. And I knew that my message would be this very early on because my mom worked at North General Hospital in Harlem. And there was a rehabilitation center on the third floor, and I would see these victims of a drug circumstance walk in and out of that building in hopes of straightening out their lives, but it just looked like a cold life to live. And I knew I might have some problems, but it would never be that. And so I wanted to spread the good word to the good people in my generation not to be involved with drugs. I used that mic to say something. I understood the power of it, and I understood what hip-hop really was. Hip-hop was community. It was actually more than community, more than just the music. Now, we're familiar with the five elements of hip-hop, yeah? Give them to me, what are they? Yeah. 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 Knowledge. How about that? Last in the lineup, but should actually be first. And, amazingly enough, it's often forgotten when people talk about the elements of hip-hop. Knowledge is almost always left out. Hip-hop community, more than music. It was more than a feeling. It was truth encapsulated in meaningful lyrics that helped broaden one's perspective. Do you remember the first hip hop record you heard? What was it?
MC Lyte.
Salt and Pepper. Insane in the Memory. That was your first? She said, Sugar Hill Gang. Hip hop. That's all the Stephanie's babies. Where hip-hop was created. So I got to hear music in the Bronx prior to it trickling down into Harlem, into Brooklyn, into Queens, into the other boroughs. And I got a chance to hear Shot Rock from the Funky 4+1 Mirror, and the Treacherous 3, and Curtis Blood, and this man right here, Ticket to Ride. One person. I tell you what, this record right here gave me inspiration to talk about the things that were really serious in the community. Ticket to Ride, White Line Highway. Tell all your friends they can go my way. Pay your toll, sell your soul, pound for pound, cost more than gold. The longer you stay, the more you pay. My white lines go a long way, either up your nose or through your veins with nothing to gain except killing your brain. Now those are lyrics that mean something. That's Melly Mel, Grandmaster Flash, Furious Five. Those were lyrics, when you heard them, were powerful because they were telling a story. And they were telling us exactly what was going on in our community. At that point, hip hop was meant to entertain, absolutely, but it was also meant to educate. Hip hop was a call to action, to do something, to get up and move. That's what hip hop was about. It was about inspiration. That mic, holding it, responsibility, knowing that when you touch the people, and that when you want to be heard, you still have to understand that you have to be accountable for what it is that you say. You are moving people. Do you want blood on your hands? Because what you say can lead people astray. Socially aware and conscious within hip hop, to me, means everything. Like, we talk about hip hop in a conscious sense, right? So we talk about conscious rappers. Who's one? Talib Kweli.
Most Def.
Most Def. KRS-One. We got a lot, right? So, Common, Professor Griff, Public Enemy, Chuck D. Conscious to me means awake, right? It means to be awake, to be aware. So we can look at these rappers as possibly saying things that ultimately shows that they are aware of their surroundings. So when you look at the opposite, when someone is not conscious, they are they're asleep.
Unaware.
Dead. I look at it as dead men walking. Talking about dead things that have no life, that move no one to be better than who they are today. This man said, and believe me, when I listen to radio today, I say, wow, where are the soldiers? That aren't afraid to see what's really going on. Underground is it, absolutely. When I can listen to the top 10 on a particular station and get all the way down from 10 to 6, and in every song some man is talking about what he's gonna do to your woman, or what he's going to do to a woman, why did we become the doormat? How did that happen? This man right here, a soldier, stand clear. Man, I talk, you can't stand where I stand. You can't walk where I walk. Sound familiar? Maybe if I said it with rhythm, you'd get it. I'd rather not. I want you to hear the words. Watch, we run New York. Policeman, we bust them out the park. I know this for a fact. You don't like how I act. You claim I'm selling crack. But you be doing that. Rather say see ya, because I would never want to be ya.
Wicked officer.
Be an officer, you wicked officer. stands. Where are soldiers? I tell you what, I remember a time when MCs had balls. They said what they felt and worried about the backlash later. That's what MCing is all about. That's what hip hop is about. It's reporting the truth. It's seeing it and speaking it as it is. If I were to just listen to what's happening on the radio now, I think we'd be in one big party. Nobody's in a struggle about anything. Everybody's got it all figured out. Hip hop is many things. It's real. It's funny, it's entertainment, but it's also commentary. But one thing it's never been, and that's ignorant. Until today. And I don't mean ignorant like stupid. I mean ignorant like unknowing. Right now, we don't know where hip hop lives. Because I hear a whole lot of people say it lives somewhere, but I know some other people that lie about where they live as well. So because a station says home of hip hop, it's fooling a nation of people into thinking that's what hip hop is. They have actually redefined what hip hop is. And I can tell you now, as Los Angeles chapter president of the Grammys, I also chair the rap committee, the rap screening committee. And that means that we all get in the room, and all of these record labels that have submitted these records to be in the hip hop category, we are a few who say, that's not hip hop, that doesn't qualify. Wait, that should be recognized. Hold on 1 second. Oh wait, this is a long list of stuff, and we don't see that guy, or we don't see that girl. We've got to enter them into this category. It becomes a struggle every year, because hip hop is changing right before our eyes. And it's hard now to get in this room and defend a category that doesn't have enough entries. But the hip hop is out there. It's out there, and you're right, it's underground. So it's up to us to discover that new talent and talk about it. To discover that new MC and say, hey, did you hear about Mayday in Detroit? She's hot. She's got a joint called 103 Bars, where she's rhyming straight through. No hook, no need for a chorus. She's spitting it like Iman out of Chicago. Or, like, it's really important that we spread the word about those who we feel can carry the torch of hip-hop. Hip-hop has always been current. It shows up on time, but why does it all of a sudden feel like hip-hop is so late? Mainstream media gets to report on news that hip-hop would have taken care of a long time ago. Chuck D would have reported that thing long before, and we would have got the right story. Hip-hop is fundamental. It's always been ahead of its time. And yet the foundation that has helped many achieve and maintain employment has rattled and rocked right beneath our feet. It is ours. Hip-hop belongs to the people. It really does. It belongs to the people, and it's up to us to stake our claim in it. And it's up to us to spread the word. So when I say, the first hip-hop record you got hip to, he says a Cypress Hill joint. Now, it's up to you to educate yourself about other music that existed before that, and I'm sure you have, because I don't think you'd be in this room. This is a room full of hip-hop heads, right? So it's up to us to teach the next one about a Sha Rock, who was the first female MC to rock the microphone. People say to me, oh, how does it feel to be the first female MC? What? What happened to Sha Rock? and Pepe Le Pew and Roxanne Shantae and the real Roxanne and Sparky B and Sweet Tea and Salt and Pepper and so many that rocked the mic long before Lyte thought she could.